So, the new Samsung S22, the S22 Plus, and the S22 Ultra have just been announced, and with it comes improvements to the camera systems. So, obviously we're going to talk about them. My name is Tom, I'm a professional photographer and videographer, so when it comes to cameras, I genuinely do have a lot of experience, and as smartphones get better and better, it's getting funner and funner to shoot with them. So today I'm actually going to not talk massively about the Samsung S22 Ultra, which is essentially the Galaxy Note squeezing back into the S22 line, even though it does have better camera specs on paper. They're relatively similar to the S21 Ultra, and most of the improvements are going to come through software changes, which we will be discussing in detail anyway. It's also just not going to be the most popular version of the phone. Most people are going to be going for the more affordable, relatively more affordable S22 and S22 Plus. There is a whole lot of if it ain't broken, don't fix it with these phones. Most of the improvements come with better software than they actually do with hardware, but there are a few small hardware improvements. So first of all, let's talk about those. Mainly it's that on the S22 and the S22 Plus, there is a bigger sensor. And as a photographer, a bigger sensor is pretty much always better. So the sensor on these phones, on their main rear camera, is a new 50 megapixel sensor with dual pixel technology. And Samsung is saying that that is 23% larger than the previous versions of the phones. This is pretty much only a good thing. A sensor size increase means better low light performance, more natural looking bokeh or blur in the background of your photos, more detail, and just genuinely overall better shots. One significant hardware change though, and I know I said I won't talk too much about the S22 Ultra, but it's the inclusion of something Samsung are calling super clear glass. And basically what this is, it is nano coated glass, which should essentially eliminate ghosting and reflections when filming or taking photos at night. This is a huge one for me personally, even though it definitely sounds like I'm overreacting. But even cameras like the iPhone 13 Pro Max have this basically massive issue where when you're filming or taking photos at night, any artificial light casts this sort of horrendous ghosting reflection on your photo or your film. And there's basically no way of getting around it. So if Samsung have fixed this, then it's actually a massive, massive win. In terms of lenses, we mainly stick to the same blueprint as the previous S21. The S22 and the S22 Plus have a main 50 megapixel camera, which is a 23 millimeter focal length. Then they have a 10 megapixel telephoto with a focal length of 69 millimeters. And then finally a 12 megapixel ultra wide with a focal length of 13 millimeters. And then the Ultra has an extra camera with a 10 megapixel 230 millimeter focal length zoom, which it carries over from the S21 Ultra. Personally, out of those lenses, I'm most excited by the 69 millimeters. I just think that's such a nice focal range. It would definitely let you take a really good range of shots. It's actually one of the things that's missing for me most from my Pixel 6, which is an insanely good photography phone, but I do sort of wish I'd gone with the Pixel 6 Pro to get access to the telephoto on that camera. So it's nice that both versions of the S22 come with this focal range. Okay, so moving on to some of the more significant software changes that are really supposed to differentiate the S22 camera line over the S21 camera line. So like the cameras on the Pixel 6 and the iPhone 13 line, Samsung is going really hard on nighttime photography. And the extra sensor size is really going to be essential to making this happen. I know I keep banging on about it, but the Pixel 6 is the first phone that I've genuinely used to take really decent low light photos, and sometimes it even outperforms my more expensive cameras due to how much AI processing is going on in these smartphones nowadays. The Samsung line is going to be using something called pixel binning, which essentially combines the 50 megapixels of that main camera into a final 12 megapixel photo. And theoretically, this does mean that you should get less noise and way better detail in those nighttime shots. The very few select low light photos we're seeing from the S22 line already do look fantastic so far, so definitely looking like this phone might be a low light beast. Now, I have very strong opinions about portrait mode on phones, because as a lucky person with access to more professional cameras, I can normally spot it just a mile off, and I just genuinely feel like it never really comes off looking that realistic. Often that is down to the edges of subjects, be it hair, hats, or glasses, and this is really where Samsung is stating that new AI improvements are going to improve performance. They're actually saying that the processing in these phones is powerful enough to pick out individual strands of hair, and again, theoretically, this should make for very good portrait mode shots. This for me really is a point of remains to be seen. It's been promised before, I'm sure it'll be promised again. For me, you just can't beat proper photo bokeh. The final large software change is the introduction of something called expert RAW shooting app. I think this is going to be in line with something like Apple Pro RAW. We might need to wait a little bit just to see how much new functionality this actually brings, because phones have been able to shoot RAW DNG for a while. We've been able to shoot RAW and then take that file and edit it on something like Lightroom or Lightroom Mobile. I'm expecting this app to essentially just streamline that RAW process. Instead of shooting RAW, loading it into Lightroom and editing it that way, you can potentially edit much faster and still retain a decent amount of control of the final photograph. Again, similar to something like Apple Pro RAW. So to wrap up, I think overall my worry with these phones is that Samsung are hugely pushing for the cameras to be a super central feature and be a huge driver of sales, where I'm just worried really about the competition. Cameras like the iPhone 13 or the Pixel 6 are hugely impressive pieces of kit, and particularly the Pixel is more affordable than the Samsung line. It does remain to be seen quite how much better the Samsung line is, because judging by the specs and the features they've highlighted, I just don't really think they're going to be different enough or good enough to potentially get people to switch from other competing phones. These don't seem to be leading features, they just seem to be kind of in line with the competition. Anyway, that's my thoughts on the S22, S22 Ultra. I'd love to hear yours down below, and I'll catch you next time.